I guess in this video, I'm going to discuss about how to convert one-dimension array to two-dimension array in csolve.net. So this code that I already written to save some time. Now here, let's execute to this code first. At here, I'm getting the output 11, 77, 88 and 55. Because at here in one-dimension array that I entered the elements 11, 77, 88 and 55. So this single dimension array, it's now converting into two dimension. So let's understand this code. So this code that I pasted here. So if you debug the code, control comes to main method. Here after that go inside. So at here I've taken single dimension array A, and here this element that I stored inside single dimension array 11, 77, 88, 55. Now here after control comes to this point. So at here that try to find A double R method in the coding. So at here it will go up, there is a A double R, and here this is at here it receive A. So it A has 11, 77, 88 and 55. And R1 receive at here 2, and this receive C1 receive 2. Now here I value initialize with 0, and here that I have taken two dimension array name is two, and here new int, so R1 and C1. So R1 is now 2 and here C1 is now 2. So at here 2 row and 2 column. Now hereafter control comes to this point. So at here value initialize to 0, R1 at here 2 is now, and here check 0 less than 2 condition is true, that coincide, x value also 0, and here c1 also 2, 0 less than 2 condition is true, that coincide. So at here a double r 0 position value is 11, that go to 2, and here x and y 0, 2, 0 and 0 position. So at here 11 comes to this point. Now hereafter I increase, and here console.writeline, this print the value of 2 or 00 position 11 print, and here that concatenate the space. So after doing that, now here after that go up, increase the value of x. X is now 1. Now at here 1 less than 2 condition is true, that coincides. So at here y value is 0 and here x value is now 1. So a double I value also increase. So I value is now at here 1, so A double R, A1 position 70 is there, so 70, and here that go to 2, Y value 0, X value 1, so 0, 1 position that go, so 70 comes to this point. Now here after I increase, so I is now 2, here after console.trend, so at here 2, 0, 1 position, Y0, X1, 0, 1 position that display at here 77. Now here after that go up, increase the value of X. X is now 2. Here that go up, check condition 2 less than 2, condition is not true. So control comes to this point. So at here now, console.write. So at here that, print the space here. Now here after that go up at this point. So at here that go up this point. So inner for loop that falls. Now here after y increase, y 1, and here 1 less than 2 condition is true, that coincide, x value start from 0 again, and here 0 less than c1, at here 2 condition is true, that coincide. So at here a double r i value is now 2, 2 position 88 is there, so that go to 2 of yx, y value is now 1. So 10 position that go 88. So this is 10 and here that come 88. Now here I increase. So I is now 3. Here after console.write. So this print. And here after that go up x increase. So x is now 1. Here 1 less than 2 condition is true, that coincide a 1 position. Sorry, a I value is now 3, 3 position 55 is there, 55 go to 2, y value add here 1 and x value both are 1. So a double r add here 3 position 55 go to 2 of 1 1. So 55 comes to this point. Now here after next is I increase. I is now 4. Here after console dot try to 1 1 position 55 that display. Here after the next is x increase. So x is now add here 1 to 2. 2 less than 2 condition false. Here control comes to this point console dot try cursor print the blank value in the new line. Here after that go up and y increase. So y is 2 now. And here y value 2, r1 value 2, 2 less than 2 condition false. So if the condition is false, so this will not coincide here that out. And here this part that has been over. Now here after control back to this point, a double r, here after this take one input from keyboard and terminate the output. So if you enter at here 4 element, so here this is not, this is the single dimension input and here this is the two dimension output. Now hereafter let's see one more thing. Suppose if I enter at here one more value 89. Now if I execute this code at here I'm getting the value 1177 8855 because at here the array size is at here two dimension, two row two columns. So at here two row two columns, that's why this neglected here. Now suppose if I give at here 3 row 3 columns. So let's give at here 3 row 3 columns. So at here R1 and row and columns 3 3. Now if I execute here, so at here 5 that print, but at here it's so giving index out of font kind of exception. So if you give at here 3 3, then you need to enter maximum minimum 9 elements inside there. So at here let's give 8 here, 6 here, 4. So and here this is so 4, sorry 5, 8, and here let's give one more 21. Now if you execute the code, so here you get the right output this time. Then here you can find total numbers of elements input 9 and here this 9 single dimension input, it's now converted into 2D. So this all about how to convert to one dimension array into two dimension in C#.NET. So I hope this video is helpful for you. So now in this video it's over. So thanks for watching. See you next video. Thank you.